This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Windows Vista, an operating system released by Microsoft in November 2006, has been criticized by reviewers and users due to issues with privacy, security, performance, driver support, and product activation. Windows Vista has been the subject of a number of negative assessments by various groups. Contents 1 Security 11 Driver Signing Requirement 12 Flaws in Memory Protection Features 2 Digital Rights Management 21 Notable Critics 22 Reaction to Criticism 3 Hardware Requirements and Performance 31 Speed 32 File Operation Performance 33 Game Performance 34 Software Bloat 35 Vista Capable Lawsuit 36 Laptop Battery Life 4 Software Compatibility 5 Removal of Features from Previous Versions 6 Removal of Announced Features 7 Pricing 8 Software Protection Platform 9 Windows Ultimate Extras 10 Idea Borrowing 11 Vistaster 12 References 13 External Links Security Driver Signing Requirement This section may contain misleading parts. Please help clarify this article according to any suggestions provided on the talk page June 2014 for security reasons. 64-bit versions of Windows Vista and of Windows 7 as well allow only signed drivers to be installed in kernel mode because code executing in kernel mode enjoys wide privileges on the system. The signing requirement aims to ensure that only code with known origin execute at this level in order for a driver to be signed. A developer, software vendor will have to obtain an Authenticode certificate with which to sign the driver. Authenticode certificates can be obtained from certificate authorities trusted by Microsoft. Microsoft trusts the certificate authority to verify the applicant's identity before issuing a certificate if a driver is not signed using a valid certificate, or if the driver was signed using a certificate which has been revoked by Microsoft or the certificate authority. Windows will refuse to load the driver. The following criticisms, claims have been made regarding this requirement. It disallows experimentation from the hobbyist community. The required Authenticode certificates for signing Vista drivers are expensive and out of reach for small developers, usually about $400 to $500 per year from VeriSign. Microsoft allows developers to temporarily or locally disable the signing requirement on systems they control by hitting F8 during boot or by signing the drivers with self-issued certificates or by running a kernel debugger at one time. A third-party tool called Atsieve existed that would allow any driver, unsigned or signed, to be loaded. Atsieve worked by installing a signed surrogate driver which could be directed to load any other driver, thus circumventing the driver signing requirement. Since this was in violation of the driver signing requirement, Microsoft closed this workaround with hotfix KB932596, by revoking the certificate with which the surrogate driver was signed. Flaws in memory protection features. Security researchers Alexander Sotirov and Mark Dowd have developed a technique that bypasses many of the new memory protection safeguards in Windows Vista, such as address space layout randomization ASLR. The result of this is that any already existing buffer overflow bugs that, in Vista, were previously not exploitable due to such features, may now be exploitable. This is not in itself a vulnerability. As Sotirov notes, what we presented as weaknesses in the protection mechanism, it still requires the system under attack to have a vulnerability. Without the presence of a vulnerability, these techniques don't really anything. The vulnerability Sotirov and Dowd used in their paper as an example was the 2007 animated cursor bug, CVE-2007-00381. Security researcher Dino Di Zovi claimed that this means that it is completely game over for Vista security, though Sotirov refuted this, saying that the articles that describe Vista security as broken or done for with unfixable vulnerabilities are completely inaccurate. One of the suggestions I saw in many of the discussions was that people should just use Windows XP. In fact, in XP a lot of those protections we're bypassing, such as ASLR, don't even exist. Digital rights management. Another common criticism concerns the integration of a new form of digital rights management DRM into the operating system, specifically the protected video path PVP, which involves technologies such as high bandwidth digital content protection HDCP and the image constraint token ICT. These features were added to Vista due to licensing restrictions from the HD-DVD Consortium and Blu-ray Association. This will concern only the resolution of playback of protected content on HD-DVD and Blu-ray discs, but it has not been enabled as of 2012. A lack of a protected channel does not stop playback. Audio plays back as normal, but high-definition video downsamples on Blu-ray and HD DVD to slightly better than DVD quality video. The protected video path mandates that encryption must be used whenever content marked as protected will travel over a link where it might be intercepted. This is called a user-accessible bus UAB. Additionally, all devices that come into contact with premium content such as graphics cards have to be certified by Microsoft before playback starts. All the devices involved are checked using a hardware functionality scan HFS to verify if they are genuine and have not been tampered with. Devices are required to lower the resolution from 1920x1080 to 960x540 of video signals outputs that are not protected by HDCP. Additionally, Microsoft maintains a global revocation list for devices that have been compromised. This list is distributed to PCs over the internet using normal update mechanisms. The only effect on a revoked driver's functionality is that high-level protected content will not play. All other functionality, including low-definition playback, is retained. Notable critics: Peter Gutman, a computer security expert from the University of Auckland, New Zealand, has released a white paper in which he raises the following concerns against these mechanisms. Adding encryption facilities to devices makes them more expensive, a cost that is passed on to the user if outputs are not deemed sufficiently protected by the media industry. Then even very expensive equipment can be required to be switched off. For example, PDIF-based, high-end audio cards. Some newer high-definition monitors are not HDCP enabled, even though the manufacturer may claim otherwise. The added complexity makes systems less reliable since non-protected media are not subject to the new restrictions. Users may be encouraged to remove the protection in order to view them without restrictions, thus defeating the content protection scheme's initial purpose. Protection mechanisms, such as disabling or degrading outputs, may be triggered erroneously or maliciously, motivating denial of service attacks. Revoking the driver of a device that is in wide use is such a drastic measure that Gutman doubts Microsoft will ever actually do so. On the other hand, they may be forced to because of their legal obligations to the movie studios. The Free Software Foundation conducted a campaign called Bad Vista against Vista on these grounds. Reaction to criticism: Ed Bott, author of Windows Vista Inside Out, has published a three-part blog which rebuts many of Gutman's claims. Ed Bott's criticisms can be summarized as follows. Gutman based his paper on outdated documentation from Microsoft and secondhand web sources. Gutman quotes selectively from the Microsoft specifications. Gutman did no experimental work with Vista to prove his theories. Rather, he makes mistaken assumptions and then speculates wildly on their implications. Gutman's paper, while presented as serious research, is really just an opinion piece. Technology writer George O. states that Gutman's paper relies on unreliable sources and that Gutman has never used Windows Vista to test his theories. Gutman has responded to both Bot and in a further article, which states that the central thesis of Gutman's article has not been refuted and the response of Bot is disinformation. Microsoft has published a blog entry with 20 questions and answers on Windows Vista content protection which refutes some of Gutman's arguments. Microsoft MVP Paul Smith has written a response to Gutman's paper in which he counters some of his arguments. Specifically, he says, Microsoft is not to blame for these measures. The company has been forced to do this by the movie studios. The protected video path will not be used for quite a while. There is said to be an agreement between Microsoft and Sony that Blu-ray discs will not mandate protection until at least 2010, possibly even 2012. Vista does not degrade or refuse to play any existing media, CDs or DVDs. The protected data paths are only activated if protected content requires it. Users of other operating systems such as Linux or Mac OS X will not have official access to this premium content. Microsoft also noted that content protection mechanisms have existed in Windows as far back as Windows ME hardware requirements and performance. According to Microsoft, nearly all PCs on the market today will run Windows Vista, and most PCs sold after 2005 are capable of running Vista. Some of the hardware that worked in Windows XP does not work, or works poorly in Vista, because no Vista-compatible drivers are available due to companies going out of business or their lack of interest in supporting old hardware. SpeedTom's hardware published benchmarks in January 2007 that showed that Windows Vista executed typical applications more slowly than Windows XP with the same hardware configuration. A subset of the benchmarks used were provided by Standard Performance Evaluation Corporation, or SPEC, who later stated that such results should not be compared to those generated while running Windows XP, even if testing is done with the same hardware configuration. SPEC acknowledges that an apple-to-apples comparison cannot be made in cases such as the one done by Tom's Hardware, calling such studies invalid comparisons. However, the Tomshardware report conceded that the SpecViewPerf tests suffered heavily from the lack of support for the OpenGL graphics library under Windows Vista. For this reason, the report recommended against replacing Windows XP with Vista until manufacturers made these drivers available. The report also concluded in tests involving real-world applications, Vista performed considerably slower, noting, "We are disappointed that CPU-intensive applications such as video transcoding with XVID DVD to XVID MPEG-4 or the main concept H264 encoder performed 18% to nearly 24% slower in our standard benchmark scenarios. Other commonly used applications, including Photoshop and WinRAR, also performed worse under Vista. Many low to middle-end machines that come with Windows Vista pre-installed suffer from exceptionally slow performance with the default Vista settings that come pre-loaded, and laptop manufacturers have offered to downgrade laptops to Windows XP for a price. However, this price is unnecessary, as Microsoft allows users of Windows Vista and Windows 7 to freely downgrade their software by installing XP and then phoning a Microsoft representative for a new product key file operation performance. When first released in November 2006, Vista performed file operations such as copying and deletion more slowly than other operating systems. Large copies required when migrating from one computer to another seemed difficult or impossible without workarounds such as using the command line. This inability to efficiently perform basic file operations attracted strong criticism. After 6 months, Microsoft confirmed the existence of these problems by releasing a special performance and reliability update, which was later disseminated through Windows Update, and is included in Service Pack 1. Nonetheless, one benchmark reported to show that, while improving performance compared to Vista's original release, Service Pack 1 does not increase the level of performance to that of Windows XP. However, that benchmark has been questioned by others within ZDNet. Ed Bott both questions his colleagues' methods and provides benchmarks that refute the results. Game performance early in Vista's lifecycle, many games showed a drop in frame rate compared to that experienced in Windows XP. These results were largely the consequence of Vista's immature graphics processing units drivers, and higher system requirements for Vista itself. Some recent benchmarks seem to suggest that, as of mid-2008, Vista SP1 is now on par with Windows XP in terms of game performance. However, game developers' recommended memory requirements on Vista are still higher, usually double than on XP. Software bloat concerns were expressed that Windows Vista may contain software bloat. Speaking in 2007 at the University of Illinois, Microsoft distinguished engineer Eric Trott said, "A lot of people think of Windows as this large, bloated operating system, and that's maybe a fair characterization, I have to admit." He went on to say that, at its core, the kernel, and the components that make up the very core of the operating system, is actually pretty streamlined. Former PC World editor Ed Bott expressed skepticism about the claims of bloat, noting that almost every single operating system that Microsoft has ever sold had been criticized as bloated when they first came out, even those now regarded as the exact opposite, such as MS-DOS Vista. Capable lawsuit. Two consumers sued Microsoft in United States federal court alleging the Windows Vista Capable marketing campaign was a bait-and-switch tactic, as some computers with Windows XP pre-installed could only run Vista Basic, sometimes not even running at a user-acceptable speed. In February 2008, a Seattle judge granted the suit class action status, permitting all purchasers in the class to participate in the case. Released documents in the case, as well as a Dell presentation in March 2007, discussed late changes to Windows Vista which permitted hardware to be certified that would require upgrading in order to use Vista, and that lack of compatible drivers forced hardware vendors to limp out with issues. When Vista was launched, this was one of several Vista launch appraisals included in 158 pages of unsealed documents. Laptop battery life. With the new features of Vista, criticism has surfaced concerning the use of battery power in laptops running Vista, which can drain the battery much more rapidly than Windows XP, reducing battery life. With the Windows arrow visual effects turned off, battery life is equal to or better than Windows XP systems with the release of a new operating system and its new features and higher requirements, higher power consumption as normal, as Richard Shim, an analyst with IDC noted, when Windows XP came out, that was true, and when Windows 2000 came out, that was true. Software compatibility. According to Gartner, Vista has been dogged by fears, in some cases proven, that many existing applications have to be rewritten to operate on the new system. Cisco has been reported as saying, Vista will solve a lot of problems, but for every action, there's a reaction, and unforeseen side effects and mutations networks can become more brittle. According to PC World, software compatibility issues, bug worries keep businesses from moving to Microsoft's new OS, citing concerns over cost and compatibility. The United States Department of Transportation prohibited workers from upgrading to Vista. The University of Pittsburgh Medical Center said that the rollout of Vista is significantly behind schedule because several key programs still aren't compatible, including patient scheduling software. As of July 2007, there were over 2,000 tested applications that were compatible with Vista. Microsoft has published a list of legacy applications that meet their works with Windows Vista software standards, as well as a list of applications that meet their more stringent certified for Windows Vista standards. Microsoft has released the Application Compatibility Toolkit 50 application for migrating Vista incompatible applications, while virtualization solutions like VirtualBox, VirtualPC 2007 or those from VMware can also be used as a last resort to continue running Vista incompatible applications under legacy versions of Windows. Microsoft also provides an upgrade advisor tool that must be installed and an internet connection is required, which can be used on existing XP systems to flag driver and application compatibility issues before upgrading to Vista. Removal of features from previous versions. Main article, list of features removed in Windows Vista. Windows Vista was criticized for removing familiar Windows features and components. A quite exhaustive list of removed features covers the removals which were deemed unnecessary and unjustified by Windows XP users upgrading to Vista. Removal of announced features. Microsoft has also been criticized for removing some heavily discussed features such as Next Generation Secure Computing Base in May 2004, WinFS in August 2004, Windows PowerShell in August 2005, though this was released separately from Vista prior to Vista's release, and is included in Vista's successor, Windows 7, Secured Support in May 2006, PC-to-PC synchronization. In June 2006, the initial three pillars in Vista were all radically altered to reach a release date. Pricing. Microsoft's international pricing of Vista has been criticized by many as too expensive. The differences in pricing from one country to another vary significantly, especially considering that copies of Vista can be ordered and shipped worldwide from the United States. This could save between $42.26 and $314.200 in many cases. The difference in price is significantly greater than was the case for Windows XP in Malaysia. The pricing for Vista is at around RM799-$244 per €155 at the current exchange rate. United Kingdom consumers could be paying almost double their United States counterparts for the same software. Microsoft has come under fire from British consumers about the price it is charging for Vista. The latest version of Windows, British and French customers will pay double the US price. The upgrade from Windows XP to Vista Home Basic will cost £100, €126, while American users will pay only £51, $100, €64. Computer active. Since the release of Windows Vista in January 2007, Microsoft has reduced the retail and upgrade price point of Vista. Originally, Vista Ultimate full retail was priced at $399, and the upgrade at $259. These prices have since been reduced to $319 and $219 respectively. Software protection platform. Vista includes an enhanced set of anti-copying technologies, based on Windows XP's Windows Genuine Advantage, called Software Protection Platform SPP. In the initial release of Windows Vista without Service Pack 1, SPP included a reduced functionality mode, which the system enters when it detects that the user has failed product activation or that the copy of Vista is identified as counterfeit or non-genuine. A Microsoft white paper described the technology as follows: the default web browser will be started and the user will be presented with an option to purchase a new product key. There is no start menu, no desktop icons, and the desktop background is changed to black after 1 hour. The system will log the user out without warning. This behavior was criticized as overly draconian, especially given an imperfect false positive record on behalf of SBP's predecessor, and given at least one temporary validation server outage which reportedly flagged many legitimate copies of Vista and XP as non-genuine when Windows Update would check in and fail the validation challenge. Microsoft altered SPP significantly in Windows Vista Service Pack 1 instead of the reduced functionality mode. Installations of Vista left unactivated for 30 days present users with a nag screen which prompts them to activate the operating system when they log in, change the desktop to a solid black color every hour, and periodically warn users about software counterfeiting with notification balloons. In addition, updates classified as optional are not available to unactivated copies of Vista. Microsoft maintains a technical bulletin providing further details on product activation for Vista Windows Ultimate Extras. Windows Vista Ultimate users can download exclusive Windows Ultimate Extras. These extras have been released much more slowly than expected, with only four available as of August 2009, almost 3 years after Vista was released, which has angered some users who paid extra mainly for the promised add-ons. Barry Goffey, director of Windows Vista Ultimate for Microsoft, states that they were unexpectedly delayed on releasing several of the extras, but that Microsoft plans to ship a collection of additional Windows Ultimate extras that it is confident will delight its passionate Windows Vista Ultimate customers. Idea borrowing this section needs expansion. You can help by adding to it. October 2015. Apple has commented during a WWDC keynote that many features on Windows Vista has originated on Mac OS X Tiger. Among these features were Spotlight, Dashboard, iCal, iPhoto, and Safari RSS. On December 18, 2006, The New York Times published a sarcastic video trying to prove that Windows Vista did not copy Mac OS X Vistaster. This term was coined as a disparaging substitute for the proper name of the Vista operating system. Use of the term was popularized by its use on The Secret Diary of Steve Jobs, a technology and pop culture comedic blog where author Daniel Lyons writes in the persona of Apple Inc. founder Steve Jobs. This use is in reference to the failure of Vista to meet sales and customer satisfaction expectations. Lyons published an article in Forbes using the term, and it was soon picked up by the international media, Journal de Noticias, Radio e Televisão de Portugal, La Nación, The Chosen Ilbo, and 163.com references. Carat driver signing requirements for Windows. Microsoft retrieved the 23rd of February 2008. Carat AB alarmed about Vista security. Black Hat researcher Alexander Sodirov speaks out. Carat Nick White and Dave Marsh. The 20th of January 2007. Windows Vista Content Protection, 20 Questions and Answers. Retrieved the 22nd of January 2007. Carat Williams, Ian. The 29th of May 2007. Understanding the Impact of Windows Vista on SpecViewPerf Performance Measurement. Standard Performance Evaluation Corporation. Retrieved the 29th of October 2008. Carat Williams, Rob. The 29th of January 2007. Windows Vista Gaming Performance Reports. TechGagecom. Retrieved the 26th of May 2007. Carat McDougall, Paul. InformationWeCom. InformationWeCom. Retrieved the 6th of August 2010. Office 2007. Information Week. Retrieved the 22nd of May 2007. Retrieved the 1st of May 2016. Carat Hands-On, A Hard Look at Windows Vista. The 10th of November 2006 p. Responsibility. Intwensnuseu Josiondeskiam Chosunkum. The 28th of August 2008 retrieved the 11th of June 2010. Dina Dublin, Maria Clave, David Marquardt, Charles Noska, Helmut Panka, Mason Morfitt, John W. Stanton. Senior Leadership Team. Satya Nadella CEO, Scott Guthrie, Amy Hood CFO, Chi Lu, Terry Meyerson, Harry Shum, Kevin Turner COO. Corporate VPs Joe Belfiore, Richard Rashid SVP S. Somasegar SVP. Divisions. Engineering Groups. Mobile Skype Unit. Digital Crimes Unit. Garage Press. Research Studios. Net Foundation. Outercurve Foundation. Estates. Microsoft Redmond Campus. Microsoft Tallow. Microsoft Algeria. Microsoft Egypt. Microsoft India. Microsoft Japan. Product Families. Operating Systems. Windows Software. Office Servers. Visual Studio. Hardware. HoloLens. Lumia. Surface. Xbox. Web Properties. Bing. Channel 9. Codeplex. Developer Network. MSN. Officecom. OneDrive. Outlookcom. TechNet. Windows Store. Conferences. Build. Mix. PDC. Techt. WinHack. WPC. Criticism. Bundling of Microsoft Windows. Clippy. ILU. Internet Explorer. Microsoft Bob_NSAKEY Windows 2000 Mi XP Vista Xbox 360 Litigation Alcatel Lucent v Microsoft Apple v Microsoft European Union Microsoft Competition Case Microsoft v Lindos Microsoft vs Microsoft Microsoft v Shaw United States v Microsoft Acquisitions 6 Wunderkinder Altamira Software Aquantiv Azixi The Blue Ribbon Soundworks Bungie Callista Technologies Colloquy Connectix Consumers Software Danger Faircast FASA Studio Fast Search High Heat, Major League Baseball Hotmail JellyfishCom LinkExchange Lionhead Studios Massive Incorporated Mobile Data Labs Mojang Nokia Devices and Services Onfolio Pondo Networks Perceptive Pixel Placeware PowerSet ProClarity Rare Revolution Analytics ScreenTonic Secure Islands Skype Sunrise Atelier SwiftKey Winternals Software Telio Telekinesis Research Telme Networks Twisted Pixel Games Vermeer Technologies Vizio Corporation Vividi Defunct Volumetrics VX Stream WEBTV Networks Xamarin Yammer UP. Category Commons Microsoft Portal Wiki Project.